The tier 3 pack-a-punch crystal schematic has an insane cooldown of 3 days. This can be very discouraging to players who want to jump right into tier 3 and grind out as many contracts as possible. But how annoying is it to pack-a-punch your weapon in-game? How much time do you need to waste before you can earn enough points for tier 3 pack-a-punch? Well, today we're going to play 3 games. One with a tier 2 pack-a-punch crystal, another with a tier 1 pack-a-punch crystal, and one more with no pack-a-punch crystal, and see just how long it takes to get tier 3 pack-a-punch. Let's get started. Alright, game number 1. We are going to start this game with a double pack-a-punch crystal here. Now clearly pack-a-punch isn't the only thing that affects your weapon's damage, you also have ether tools, and so I thought the most common ether tool everybody would have is a rare ether tool. So that's what we're going to use for these tests, just to kind of keep a consistent variable here. So the name of the game here is going to be doing contracts as fast as possible, and the fastest contracts are going to be HETs, cargo deliveries, and then we can start getting into like spore contracts and even ether extractors and maybe raid weapon stashes. Even though this is a tier 1 contract, we have a tier 2 pack punch crystal, so that means this guy is probably going to go down pretty quickly. And just like that, he's gone. Yep, pretty darn good. Self revive, stamina up. Oh yes, we've got perks. Also, it would be more advantageous of you to do tier 2 contracts, clearly, because they have higher payouts. And in theory, that does mean you could probably go on into the tier 3 area and do like the cargo delivery contracts and even the spore control contracts, because you don't really need guns with those two contracts. But if the whole hypothesis is that people aren't comfortable going into tier 3 without tier 3 pack-a-punch, then I doubt they'd be comfortable going into tier 3 without any weapons at all. Got a quick little cargo delivery here. Now, even though it says 2,000 points for this contract payout, there's a little bug here. This should give us 3,000. Yes, indeed it did. Now, this side of the map down here is really good. I really like a lot of these contracts. You get a lot of good HVTs and spore controls and all that stuff. Now, obviously, contracts isn't the only thing you do to get money. Cash registers tend to have a couple hundred bucks every single time. So as you're looting, just be sure to check out all of the cash registers and all the loot. Here's a tier 2 HVT. A little bit hard without tier 3 pack-a-punch and just a blue rarity gun compared to what I'm used to using, but not too bad. Hey, there's an epic ether tool. I'm gonna exfil with that bad boy. That's awesome. Also, if you have the space, take these items worth a couple hundred points and sell them at buy stations. That can get you a lot more cash than you think. I guess now would be a good time to show you this RAM 9 build that I got going on here. It's nothing crazy. I'm still ranking it up. All right, that is another contract done, and we are so close. We are one away. Now, this must be a new HVT spot. I've never seen it up here before. Honestly, though, I really like this. This is pretty cool. With a double pack-a-punch, this should go down pretty well. There we go. Nice and good. And we got speed cool again. Cool. Now we can loot all of the good stuff in here. Look at all the good stuff in here. There's a turret circuit that we'll take. There's another quick revive can, another Casimir. That's awesome. Another quick revive can. Dang it. This place is so good for loot. A large rucksack. And look at that. A couple more turret circuits. That's amazing. But now we have points for a pack-a-punch already. And so now all we need to do is fly on over there and pack-a-punch it. Of course, there's going to be a little bit of RNG of where this pack-a-punch gets placed. And it looks like somebody's playing just outside of tier 3. Not to worry. I will go get them after I go pack-a-punch, because we are on the clock and I got to get ready to stop my timer here, because we got it right now. 28:25. That is when we got our pack-a-punch 3. Now let's go save this guy. And somebody else picked him up. Cool. Now you might say to yourself, Donuts, how good is a pack-a-punch 3 blue rarity weapon in tier 3 anyway? Don't you need an epic or a legendary ether tool for tier 3? Well, let's take a look. This is a heavy armored zombie and it's dead. Look at how much damage we're doing with these critical shots. We are very much handling ourselves very okay here. This is easily enough damage to do spore control contracts or outlast contracts or even raid weapon stash contracts here. This is very, very manageable. Pack-a-punch is way more important than rarity. What do you know? My man needs help again. And I'm not gonna lie, only having 30 minutes after getting pack 3 is kind of a shock to me. I thought it would actually be faster than that. And I'll be honest too, it felt like a decent game too. It didn't feel like I was taking super long to get contracts done. It didn't feel like I was doing them super quick. It felt pretty average. Kinda makes me worried for what we're gonna find in our next couple games. Alright, game number 2. We're still gonna use our blue ether tool, but we're only gonna get a pack punch 1 crystal here. Personally, I feel like this is a little little bit better of a spawn. I like the contracts around here a little bit more. And like I said, this spore control contract can be done fairly quickly, especially in tier 1. Also, it spawns in a good amount of zombies, so if you go for headshots, you should be able to get a little bit of bonus points here. Ah, crap, I just put on the purple ranch on my gun. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Treyarch, you really need to increase that stash size. And there's a Pack-a-Punch 1 crystal, isn't that lucky? Well, I apologize for the a little bit less than scientific testing that's going to be present now because of that stupid misclick I had. But in all honesty, it really shouldn't skew our results that bad. There's an HVT down nice and quickly. There's a green ether tool. Again, I think this is a new HVT area. I kind of don't know where to go for here. Is it just inside? Oh yeah, there we go. All right, cool. I feel like this is the most likely scenario here. I feel like it's not too uncommon to find the pack one crystals, so I betcha people have plenty of those. That being said, we are gonna go into tier 2. Now I know I didn't accidentally put my tool to epic instead of keeping it at rare rarity, but I assure you having a blue tool pack one in here is very, very possible. And especially when you're doing these contracts like cargo delivery, your pack-a-punch weapon doesn't really matter. I know it's not like new content, but I really do appreciate the fact that they mix up some of these contracts every season and like mid-season update too. It keeps it fresh enough to where these contracts, while they still do get repetitive, they're not like the same contracts that we've been doing for the entire year. Although I would love some new contracts, that would be pretty fun. And once again, even though it only says 2,000 points, it's gonna give us 3,000 points. There's a glitch in the UI, there's Quirk Revive, ooh, and a Mortar Strike. And I'll take this time to show you the build of the HRM9 that I'm using this game. Again, nothing special. I managed to get that 50 round mag on it, but other than that, it's pretty meh. Now I know I have enough points for tier 2 pack-a-punch, but I've not been around the tier 2 pack-a-punch yet, so we're gonna keep on grinding these contracts. Now the last game we just had, this contract was up on that tower over there. Is that gonna be the same thing even though Dokubi's there? No, it's in a different spot. Isn't that cool? Oh, this guy's a disciple. This might be a little bit difficult without pack-a-punch too. Not unmanageable. Definitely a lot slower than usual, though. All right, we're in the neighborhood for 2-2 pack-a-punch, and that should be good. Now, believe it or not, this ether extractor contract can be done fairly quickly. That being said, I do wish I had death perception on. Although, in tier 2, you do have to do 5 of them, which can be pretty difficult. But especially in tier 1, these guys are not bad whatsoever. Oh boy, who's right there? Oh no. All right, finally a moment of solace. We can get this done, and that should be it. Boom. Nice. And we're right close by to another cargo delivery. And this contract should get us really close. We're just a couple hundred off here, which is why you probably should be looting a lot more than I did. But I think I'm going to try to do this ether nest, see if that gets me any points, at least some zombie kills we can do. Some extra zombie points in here. See what's in the registers, a couple hundred. And in here, there's another 100. Not going to lie, I thought it'd be a lot more than that. Luckily, I have one thing, turret circuit, that we can sell at this buy station, and now we have enough for pack 3. Now, this is probably not the best idea, but we're gonna take this basically damaged car, and we're gonna go here into the tier 3 area, where the storm's actually at. Oh my goodness, that's crazy, isn't it? And critical damage already. Let's go. And get ready, we're in here, and 2137. And we'll see how good it does. Obviously, it's going to be a little bit better because we accidentally put on that epic rarity. But with the tier 3 pack-a-punch gun, we could still do quite a bit of work to this horde right here. Look at that. That's pretty darn good. And with this insta-kill, it's going to be even better. Look at that. Oh yeah, that's so good. More or less, that gave us 20 minutes inside of tier 3, which, again, honestly kind of surprises me. Now, 20 minutes is still 20 minutes. It's still pretty darn good. But as I'm doing this, the natural next question is, when can you go into tier 3 without a triple pack-a-punched gun? Like, if you don't have that pack 3 crystal, can you go into tier 3 with like a blue pack 2 gun or a purple pack 2 gun? Like, what's the rarity you need to counterbalance not having that tier 3 pack-a-punch? Interesting question that I'm definitely gonna go over in a different video. So be sure to subscribe for more. And finally, our third and final game. This game, we are not using any pack-a-punch, but I am most excited for this game. This is going to be a true test of really how long it takes. Now I'm gonna try to keep it this rare ether tool without accidentally misclicking these guys, and clearly we are gonna have to do some tier one contracts first. Now it's been a while since I haven't had a pack-a-punch on my gun here, so we're gonna see just how terrible it really is. And you know what? It's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. I thought that would be way more annoying because we already got it done. Look at that. Not only am I gonna pick up this cargo contract, I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna smack the pack-a-punch machine because I want to keep my gold camo on this gun. I'll throw up the class because this is actually not the WSP Stinger, or it's not the WSP Swarm either. It's the WSP 9. And I gotta say, there's like no recoil on this gun. It's super fun. Ooh, Deadshot schematic. Isn't that nice? Now, we have enough points for pack-a-punch 1, and that's what I feel like some people would do, but we're gonna try to be a little bit smarter than that. You see, especially in tier 1, there is a contract reward of a pack-a-punch 1 crystal that is fairly common. So instead of wasting 5,000 points on pack-a-punch 1, we're just gonna do some contracts so that way we can get up even more points for pack-a-punch 2 at the same time as grinding out that, hopefully, pack-a-punch 1 crystal. Of course, this is probably gonna be the one game where I don't get a pack 1 crystal really easily. Again, not so bad with just a blue ether tool. That's a lot more. And another schematic, look at that. But unfortunately, no pack-a-punch crystal. This is getting concerning. We might just have to bite the bullet and go. There's not a lot of contracts nearby. Look at these defend the ground station contracts. Treyarch, get rid of those guys. No one wants to play that for 5 minutes during a match. They're great. They're great ideas. Really, they are. They're just not for zombies. We're going to try something a little risky, not too risky, but I just want to see how this does. We're going to go into tier 2 and we're going to do a cargo delivery. This is not uncommon. Cargo deliveries are really easy. As you saw last game, we were just kind of doing them over and over again. And here we are, no pack-a-punch in tier 2. It's not that bad. We can still hold our own here. Look at that. Yeah, it's not bad at all. So you can definitely do some contracts. Now, maybe not an HVT, but spore control, cargo delivery, all the good stuff, you know. All right, if this doesn't have a pack-a-punch crystal, then unfortunately, dang it, yep, we're gonna have to go do pack-a-punch manually. Actually, never mind, there's a cargo contract right there that we can do. All right, hopefully this has a, nope, okay, all right. Well, I am curious. Let's see how a raid weapon stash contract does in tier 2 with no pack-a-punched gun. Not as good as I want it to be, obviously, but who knows, maybe this could add some excitement into this. All right, we dealt with some hordes. We just had to train them around a little bit, but overall, this was very, very doable. And still nothing. Bummer. That being said, as I make my way to pack-a-punch, there's this cargo delivery that just popped up, so we'll do that. Again, looting the registers that we can. No pack-a-punch crystal. Dang it. All right, well, let's head on over to pack-a-punch then. We'll have to do it the normal way. But that is a good strategy for you to utilize. If you're doing pack one contracts, there is a decent chance of it dropping a pack one crystal. So instead of just pack-a-punching and using the 5,000 points, keep doing tier one contracts until you get that crystal, and then you can just hop leapfrog over to tier two. But I think for our test here, this is a pretty good experiment of doing it all the legit way. And then if you get lucky with a contract, it's just bonus time. So I like it. All right, there's pack two, and we are really close to pack three already. And just like that, we've got enough for tier three pack-a-punch. And luckily, it's fairly close, so we can just go up on this crane and jump off. There's some mega abominations going ham on some people already, dang it. All right, let's go. Let's see. Well, actually, let's see. This is tier two. This is rare tier two pack-a-punch. Yeah, it's not great. I wouldn't recommend this for tier three, but it's definitely possible. Look at that. Yeah, not great for contracts, but definitely possible. 1626. 1626. Now, what does a pack 3 look like in tier 3? Well, you can deal with zombies. Well, that's a bad example. You got this whole horde here, and honestly, it's not super great like we're used to, but it's very manageable. If you're doing a spore control contract, a cargo delivery, an outlast raid weapon stash, this is very, very possible. Look at this, we're handling it like a boss. But really, that's the barrier to entry, and honestly, that's not bad whatsoever for tier 3. Look at this mimic that we're already killing. Look at that, we did that in like less than a clip. That's really good. Now, disciples on the other hand, yeah, that's probably not gonna be super great. But not impossible either. Look at that. And a mangler, let's see what a mangler does. This is one clip, blue pack 3, and the mangler's dead. Now, as a side note, I think I'm gonna use one of my epic ether tools here.
And we just got a flawless Ethereum crystal. I think I've gotten that all of like one time.
You know a pet peeve of mine lately? It's when people say, hey, let's do the ether worm in this game, but then at the end of the game, they don't show up.
I think we were gypped, man. I think we were gypped.
It's just rude, you know? I got all geared up, used an ether tool on it. This guy's in the same boat. He came with me. It looks like they want to do it, but y'all, you only got 10 minutes. That ain't gonna happen with like two or three people. Fail the plan is plan to fail. I mean, it looks like they're going for it. Looks like they're trying it, but man, I don't know if you got enough time.
But do I? There's a lot of them though. Do I go help them?
Hey, there's Zircon Scale.
Zircon Scale? Sorry, Zircon Scale.
I mean, I did get all ranked up, didn't I?
No, I guess I should go, huh?
Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no.
Okay, well, I definitely waited too long. That's okay though.
Man, I really wanted to fight that fight. They just took too long. I wasn't gonna stand there and wait for them. I mean, y'all know my stance about the red worm. If you see someone in chat doing it, you gotta do it. Not only is it really fun, but also I still don't have that Scorcher schematic.
I gotta say, these later game exfils are fun again. Lots of zombies, some boss zombies in there. It's pretty fun. This is pretty good. Let's try not to miss this one. I just want to get some manglers out of here before I go on, and then we'll pop this guy so we get some safety here. Hopefully Peter Griffin jumps on with me here. Oh my goodness, he just said GG. The man said GG. They definitely won the worm. They definitely beat the worm. Dang it, I should have stayed.
So let's recap. Our double pack-a-punch game took us 16 minutes and 32 seconds to get 15,000 points for pack 3. Our single pack-a-punch game took us 23 minutes and 23 seconds to get pack-a-punch level 3. And our no pack-a-punch game took us 29 minutes and 34 seconds to get pack-a-punch 3. Now, if you're used to, I don't know, say tombstone glitching, absolutely any time not being in tier 3 sounds not great. But when it comes to the practicality of going into tier 3, we were just using this blue ether tool. I'm positive with double pack-a-punch and an epic ether tool, you can jump right into tier 3. With a legendary pack 2 or even a legendary pack 1, it might be possible to jump into tier 3 as well. So the strategy then becomes using your legendary ether tool with your single pack crystal, and then maybe the next game you'll use your epic tool with a double pack-a-punch crystal. So for those two games, you can start off in tier 3 with no grinding beforehand. And then as you saw, even the game after that, you could use your rare ether tool and your flawless Ethereum crystal to keep going back into tier 3. Combine your schematics with, I'm sure, your decent looking stash with all of your good loot. There's some strategy to maintain your ability to go into tier 3. Of course, tombstone glitching and having a wallet would be the best, and lowering the schematic time is what everybody wants, of course. But it's not impossible, and it's not really that offensive either. Especially that second game with just the single pack-a-punch crystal we used. If we paired that up with that epic ether tool, I bet you more than anything we could have gone into tier 3 with just tier 2 pack-a-punch. Now, if you've been playing all day and all of your schematics are gone, is it annoying to grind up to tier 3 pack-a-punch and only have like 15 or 20 minutes in tier 3? Absolutely. But all of these tools have a day or less cooldown, and the first two pack-a-punch crystals also have less than a day cooldown. So if you're using your stash wisely and you really want to be in tier 3 for a long good chunk of your play session, you can do it if you're smart enough. That being said, Treyarch, I just got a tier 3 pack-a-punch crystal, which is awesome, except for the fact my stash is full and there's nothing I want to replace it with. So it looks like the next game I play, I'm gonna have to use it, or I'm gonna have to either keep it in my inventory or destroy it. Just a daily reminder, I would love to see an increased stash size, especially because, you know, my purchased is 30 and my rewards are 18. I have 5 times more stuff not in my stash than I do in my stash. Just saying. Just saying. And especially because it seems like you, Treyarch, have buffed the tier 3 contract rewards. Don't believe me? Why don't you check out this video and stay beautiful?